Welcome to Kenad Housen's Sci-Fi Station.
Okay, so I'm here now to review Transformers the Movie, the 1986 animated film, obviously based on the Transformers television series. It was released in my home country of the United Kingdom on December the 12th, 1986. And basically, the film is set between the second season of Transformers and the third season. It's actually set 20 years after the second season. Although a lot of characters in the second season don't appear, it's very strong of characters in the first season and upcoming third season characters, because this script was in the works before some of the season 2 characters were even invented. The film features brilliant voice work. You've got Eric Idle, Judd Nelson, Leonard Nimoy, obviously, you know, most people know as Mr. Spock. Personal favourite of mine, you've got Robert Stack, who, for those that don't know him, he was the host of the TV show Unsolved Mysteries, which is one of my personal favourite things to watch. It's just this awesome old show where one minute you are looking at murders that were never solved, and the next minute they're talking about Bigfoot. It's brilliant, especially in my case, when I watch it with my missus and she's screaming bullshit when they start talking about Bigfoot or UFOs. But still, you know, sidetrack aside, you know, Robert Stack is the man. But on top of that, you've got Peter Cullen, the original voice of Optimus Prime, and Frank Welker, the original voice of Megatron. And it's also the final film role for Orson Welles and Scatman Crothers. Bearing in mind the fact that this film is getting on in years, it's probably strange that I will say I don't want to go down the route of too many spoilers. But what I will say is that for a film you think is based on a kids franchise, there's a lot of deaths in this. Warriors on both sides of the combat, good and evil, both get blown away. And I'm not saying blown away as in the robots, as in they fall on the floor and stop working. I am talking, you see the life escape from their eyes, you see flames coming off their body. It is well apparent that they are dead. Which is actually kind of harsh for a kid's film. And I'll admit, you know, when I was young, it did bring some tears to my eyes. So if you're going to show this a kid, I'd seriously think about how they are likely to respond. Because there has been cases of this film apparently making kids not eat for several days and not leave their bedrooms. But to me, this sort of stuff just gives it its depth. Basically, even if you're not into the Transformers, to me, there is a good sci-fi film here about a war, about loss, about the struggle to survive. You have some fantastic one-liners worthy of an action film, epic battles, and you have a soundtrack which is absolutely to die for. It is this perfect 80s light metal, industrial sounding, awesome collection of music. And I was lucky enough that when I was rather young, older than when I'd seen this film obviously, but around the 14 age point, a friend of mine, Andrew, brought the CD to this, the soundtrack, and he let me burn it to my PC, and I still have songs from this film on my mobile phone so I can listen to them on the way to work now. That is how awesome the music is. The music, even away from this film, is so great you can't help but listening to it and wanting to bust out a tune yourself. Okay, well, I highly recommend you watch this one yourself, and I'm going to end this here, saying that's Kerr 9000 signing out. Ba weep grana weep ninny bon.